Do you want a heat tool without breaking the bank? If you want to know more about this affordable heat tool, just keep on watching! Okay, so I threw the box already because I've had this for almost around 1 year already when I was still a student. And of course, if you're a student, you have limited amount of money, resources. So you just make of what you can. Okay, so let's try this and check this heating tool or heat tool that I got. This is from the shop in Shopee, which I'll be showing the shop name here. So this is the heating tool. So there are two colors that are available, the white and the black one. So I got the black one, and here you can see this is the body, and then this is the tip where the hot air will go out. And there's a stand here which you can use to keep the heat tool in place so that it will not move around. And here we have the switch. Take note that there's no adjustment of the heat settings, only on and off is the plug. We have at 220 volts, so this can withstand up to 230 volts, 50 to 60 hertz, 300 watts. So for the length of the heat tool, we have at around 9 inches including the tip already. And for the length of the wire, so this is around 35 inches. Let me just plug this so you can hear the sound that it makes when it's turned on. So this is the sound that it makes when it is turned on. And now let's try to use this in one of my cards. We'll be making this cute elephant card. Let's start with a 5x4 inches white cardstock base card. And then I'm just using this Ranger's letter set, hello set, and just putting my clear stamps in place. And then I'm just placing my stamps and my cardstock in my stamping platform. You can make one also, which I'll be linking the DIY tutorial in the upper right corner. I'm using Colorbox Black Pigment ink here. And then after the stamping is okay, I'll be using on top Versamark ink for the hello. I'm using Black Chukineko embossing powder. And the moment that we've all been waiting for, I will not be putting any cuts or any fast forward in this clip so that you'll know, you'll have an estimate of how long it takes for the embossing powders to melt. So I usually start from the below because I find this less warping of the embossing powder. And then after the embossing powders have melted from below, from the heat when applied below or under the paper, that's the time when I put additional heat on top. As you saw earlier, the embossing powder started melting at around 15 seconds of heat. This is my favorite part in embossing, when the magic starts to happen. So now I'll just apply heat from top so that it will seal it completely and the embossing powder will evenly melt. Okay, so now I'm quite happy with the result. So I'm just coloring in the elephant with my Copic markers. I'm just speeding up the process here. For the background, I think I'll be using a snowing stencil here. So let me just attach my stencil. I use washi tape because I don't have the blue tape. So I just use washi tape to attach my stencil in place so that it will not move around. I'll be using distress ink spun sugar for the inner portion and then the Victorian velvet for the outer portion. The paddle brush that I'm using here is just cheap makeup brushes that I got from Divisoria. If you're enjoying this video, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and give this video a thumbs up. So here, I'm just putting Victorian velvet at the outer sides of the card. For the inside, I'll just use this white base cardstock also. And then just put some thank you sentiments and also a cute elephant at the bottom. This card is dedicated to all frontliners who are risking their lives to fight this pandemic. Again, I'll just speed up the coloring process. I'm using Zig Clean Color Real Brush Pen here. So, I'll just stick the top card to the base card using the glue tape. My thoughts on the heat tool is that it is affordable. I got this at around 380 pesos from a local Shopee shop. And then I'll put the link of the shop and the shop name in the description down below also. Oh yeah, just like before, this video is not sponsored. I'm just sharing to you the heat tool that I've discovered last year. And upon 1 year of using it, I kind of like it. So, I have no experience in using the more commercial and expensive heat tool, but this kind of works for me. And as long as I use the technique of putting the heat below the or under the paper, I did not have any problems of the powders flying around. Thank you if you've reached this far. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And please watch my other YouTube videos as well. Till next video. Bye-bye!